Uganda, Lake Bunyonyi, West Uganda, and going to an island.
And I'm so, so grateful that he shared that piece with us. So much passion, so much energy. Please join us tomorrow, same place. We talk about, like I said, modern folklore, social change reflected in oral literature. We shall have more performances. So have a good night, get home safely, and see you tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
About building that kind of world.
Because you can, because you're saying 100 years in Kampala. Yeah, I have 100 years from now. You know, we have Vision 2040. You know, and they showed us those pictures of Vision 2040. As we looked at those pictures, we are just laughing, but the pictures are there. You know, and the story is there, so you can also create that kind of story, because it's possible. You know. Our president is already giving us that vision. Why not you, the writer? Write about it, you know? Okay? He said that for us to write a story, we must know language. Yeah? To describe the environment. Don't use adjectives that you're not sure of.
But every culture has a way of remembering itself, yeah. And one of the ways in which a culture remembers itself is through its stories. Now, these stories can be told by anyone, and it is not like a portion in the sense that there are only certain people in the society that have been given the authority to tell these stories. Every story that is told by every person in a culture constitutes what we would like to call oral literature.
The family and its chance and role to teach the kids the oral texts of the people is slowly dying out. I lament about this. I know it is one of those things. I have a daughter who speaks my language and speaks the mother's language, and she's 2 years. And I always get amused how I speak to her and she speaks to me in my language and she speaks to the mother in her language, and somehow she knows that. But it's quite interesting then how I can be able to train her in my oral traditions. And the mother trains her in her oral traditions, and she gets what he calls a hybrid tradition. It is quite interesting because the family should do that. But we also know that the family is not doing that anymore. And if it is doing it, it is probably getting what is in the text and going to read to the kids and saying this is the oral literature of your people.
So I think what we don't do as we strive for this existence of a hybrid nature where everybody is happy, I feel like if we made our local languages and the thing that we produce as important, as valuable, as worthy of, we put money in it, for example, and said this is something important, put it on a pedestal and said, even poetry is coming to perform in poetry in Uganda, they're just as important as the one who performs in English, or a book written in Uganda, or any other African language is just as important as the other, then we start to grow that interest in our languages and start to give it respect and a space.
Tulikuwa na kitu moja in common, na ni a story kwa book, ndo tulifeel most at home. Na licha pia life story yake siku moja, tukidiscuss kapoa makanishuo vile imekuwa disgusting, kama kuna chafu ya chuo, na vile so far bado umekuwa kifeel ni kaa, kuna kitu wanafaa kwa atone, but anafeel ni kaa God amenileave alone, na kwa hii life ajapata mtu aneza trust. Mimi nilimwona kada ya mwona half barrel kwa dance.
Zabu nefeza, ze munange sirina, echo chenina munange ze chenguwa, yuka tambula. Olongo sempi sazo, ojode mwongkwane, ojode mwongkwane, ojode mwongkwane, wankwana mwinyo, ewa fete batukwana, weba te wankwanisa tamiro, ewa fete batukwana na tamiro. Wankwana mwinyo, ewa fete batukwana, weba te wankwanisa ntawaza wakade, ewa fete batukwanisa ntawaza wakade. Kwe kata alijirianza siri mpetiaru la kubanga nezi koko lima zona zona kali maji. Kwe kata alijirianza siri mpetiaru la kubanga nezi koko lima zona zona kali maji. Ojode mwongkwane, ojode mwongkwane, ojode mwongkwane.
She was in an airplane, but the conditions were unfavorable. Just
at one moment, I heard to vanish into thin air, but little did I know they were human beings who once lived with us on planet Earth, but could disappear when annoyed.
A train story, you just say whatever comes into your mind. He can start then. No, I'm not meaning to start right now, but if you want to make a train story, He can say anything that comes in his mind, then the rest will follow as you just also speak whatever is in your mind. You just, okay, it's like the way you express your feelings, like you just say anything that comes in your head, that's all.
Writing is not just that moment when you sit and you write. You can be creative even as you do other things. You can think about the things that you want to write about at any time. Yeah?
Today we went to a school, and after that we went to an orphanage, and it was really, really amazing.